So where's the secret door?
Come on, man, what are you doing?
I know, you're looking like a chump. Guess I'm what the little... fuck? Why is there a dragon?
Paranoid!
What the shit? And that's the end of the first episode. That was a weird cliffhanger. Huh. So this is the outro. Cool. That's a cool shot. Yo. Do. Well, that was, aside from my, my ears dying, that was, Benton Alien Force, episode 1. It was interesting. A lot of crazy crap happened. Ben no longer wore the Omnitrix. Anywhere from about 3 to 6 years has passed, if I had to guess. They're 16. They made a license comment. Actually, maybe they're 15, because then Kevin could have his license. Because Ben doesn't have his license. So, I mean, likely he's under 16. So the best guess I got is 15, and then Kevin would be 16, just like Kyle. So I'm guessing 5 years later, because in the original show, Kevin 11, and Ben was 10, Ben 10. If it is 5 years in the future, that would make Kevin 16, Ben 15, Gwen 15. That looks about right. I can see that. Although they all look quite mature. So it really could be anywhere from about like 14 to 18, I guess. Even though the license comment seems to make me think on the younger side. So my guess is 15 for Ben, 16 for Kevin, 15 for Gwen. That was awesome. Another thing that was really awesome was... just this whole kind of idea, the way that he ended up putting the Omnitrix back on, that was really cool. The whole thing about Max and kind of basing the beginning of the story on Max and his potatoes. He looks exactly the same. 5 years have passed, I guess he wouldn't look too much different, but that's okay. That's actually great. Yeah. Just a lot of potatoes. Not really sure how I feel about them, but yeah, it's pretty cool stuff, and I'm really curious to see where the story goes from here. That was an interesting to be continued. I can't wait to see the second part of the premiere and see where that goes. But until then, I'm really excited, and I'm really enjoying... I enjoyed the hell out of the first episode. We got Kevin, another crazy thing. And Kevin seemed to be taking an interest in Gwen as well. That was another interesting thing. I don't know if that's foreshadowing. If that's set up for something between them, like some kind of like weird forbidden love they're gonna have, where like Kevin's a bad guy and Gwen's a good guy, but they really like each other, and like Gwen, so quote unquote, would be a little more bad for Kevin, and Kevin would be a little more good for Gwen, it'd be a whole mess. That'd be interesting, I guess. That's kind of weird, but I guess I'm curious. I'm curious to see more of Kevin. You know, he was pretty much the best character in the original series. I mean, it was Kevin, for fuck's sake. But, you know, I love Charmcaster a lot, too. But I think Kevin was so good. Kevin was Kevin. What can you say? Kevin was Kevin. And Gwen, of course. Gwen. Actually, Gwen was probably my favorite character. I think I take that comment back about Kevin. I fucking love Gwen. Gwen, by the way, her magic has gotten beast mode. She's looking awesome. Another interesting point was at the very beginning, you know, Ben was playing soccer. He's a goalie in playing soccer, kicking ass, making a big save to save the game and get the 2-1 victory, and then hitting it up with Julia? Was that her name? I feel like it was said. I want to say it was either Julie or Julia. Oh, man. I was probably totally wrong. Probably not even close, but I want to say it was either Julie or Julia. I'm going to say Julia. I'm probably totally wrong. But that was awesome, and I'm really interested now to see the second episode of Ben 10 Alien Force and the second part of Ben 10 Returns. That'll be really interesting, and I can't wait to see it. So, yeah.